So me and the Chads on Chadcraft did a talent show recently, and while I'm editing that video, I wanted to share some competitive Pokemon battles. Now why? Well, you see, for the longest time, I played Bed Wars when I wanted to just chill out and beat people in a video game with my epic, overpowering skill. Now let's see, can we get them? Can we surprise them? Probably not, but can we sneak attack? Let's see. Right now I'm wasting time. We do have 4 people versus Green's 3. Yelling at PvP is bad. Thank you. Doesn't matter, we still won. That's all that matters. But the reason for that was because I watched a lot of YouTubers that played just Bed Wars. They played a lot of Bed Wars, and so I was more interested in playing Bed Wars. But recently, I've been watching competitive Pokemon, and oh boy, it's a lot of fun. And very interestingly, I've been playing a lot of competitive Pokemon. If you don't know what Pokemon is, or how to play, here's a tutorial by the acclaimed champion himself, Wolfie VGC, right after this Wix ad.
Thank you all for enrolling in VGC 1.
So now that you've watched that and you know the basics of Pokemon, or not, who cares, let's get into the games. Okay, so what you're looking at here are the last 4 games that I've played. So, we've got this first game. Alright. No, I clicked the wrong button. She deleted the game. Well, we're not gonna watch that game.
The reason that I am showing these games is because I've played a lot of Pokemon, like probably 20 or 30 hours of competitive Pokemon in the past few days. I've played a lot of games where I was able to clutch out a victory after having a big disadvantage early game. More clarification, I am doing randoms because I don't know what I'm doing with team building. So I play the Pokemon game mode where I don't have to build a team, my opponent doesn't have to build a team, we're just given random Pokemon. Sometimes we're given really good Pokemon, sometimes we're given really bad Pokemon. Right before recording this video, I played 5 games in a row where my opponents conceded immediately after I gained a little bit of an advantage. They conceded way prematurely, and it was very strange.
So, instant replay of this game. Okay, so we start out a Heatran versus an Aromatis. I have a type advantage. They switch into a poison type, and then use Stealth Rock. So they switched into something to use Stealth Rock, okay? This player's not a complete noob. As you can see, they have a decent ranking, they've won some games, but then I switch in Tentacruel, you see they're setting up a bunch of spikes, but then I Rapid Spin and get rid of all the spikes, and then I switch in Kangaskhan and Power Up Punch. Why did they concede? They have all their Pokemon left. They could switch in Aromatis, which is resistant to all of my moves. They still have a chance, they have all their Pokemon! We're gonna say the second game. Instant replay. This game, the guy starts out by saying noob in chat. You can see we're playing the game. I'm swapping into Psychic. I have to deal with this Musharna, so I U-turn out, and then I switch in Snorlax versus the Musharna, which is really good against the Musharna. So they should switch for a physical attacker, right? But they don't, and they really should have, because see, here are Snorlax's stats, and here are Musharna's stats. Now you may notice Musharna's special attack is really high, but so is Snorlax's special defense, while Musharna's attack is really low and Snorlax's defense is really low, at least for now. They just keep hitting with Bug Buzz and then Moonlight to try to I don't know what the term would be. They're gonna outpace the Snorlax. They're not gonna outpace a Snorlax. You can't be more dirtly than a Snorlax. It's gonna dirtle and it's gonna heal. And so I keep body slamming until I can get a Paralysis, which I think I get like skip a few turns. I get it. No, never mind. I get a Paralysis on this one though. No, I get a crit here. This was a very lucky crit. I sleep talked into body slam into crit, but sometimes you get lucky. And when you just attack a bunch, you get a lot of attacks. Now, this is a thick body Snorlax versus a Camerupt, and they keep fire blasting it. You don't have any physical attacks on this Camerupt? You don't have any physical attacks against the Snorlax? Snorlax has like ridiculous hit points, ridiculous special defense, pretty good defense, but at least it's defense, not special defense. Look at this. Look, it toxics, and then I have sleep. It knows I have sleep. What is your plan? As soon as you put yourself in this position, is Camerupt his best? I guess that was his best Pokemon to deal with Snorlax? Like, you didn't even have, like, a physical attack Pokemon? I do realize that I had a x2 defense up. That actually is kind of unwinnable. Okay, this guy, his concede makes sense after I knock out his Moltres. This guy, I'm gonna just play this, okay? He sends out Deoxys attack form, which definitely outspeeds Venomoth. So he thinks I'm going to switch into a dark type. So he switches into Steelix, and then I Bug Buzz the Steelix, which does a ton of damage because Steelix has no special defense. He Mega Evolves, I Sleep Powder, and then I set up with the Quiver Dance. Not Bug Buzz. I set up with Quiver Dance to be able to take on the Deoxys, which I'm terrified of. And then he just keeps asleep with Steelix. He doesn't switch in something to sack it. He just lets me keep Bug Buzzing. and building up Quiver Dances. Like, I guess rock type is good, but look, he just loses. He just concedes with the Deoxys. He has a Deoxys. You can't beat a single Venomoth. A single Venomoth with one Quiver Dance up. Look at this guy. He's decently ranked too. He's got a ranking. Okay, he's decent. He's okay. He's won at least six games. Okay, and he concedes to a Venomoth. And in case you're curious, yes, his Deoxys could still have outspeeded me. I don't know why he conceded. So we're gonna try one more game. We're gonna see if people are just conceding constantly, or if I'm just crazy. I think I'm just crazy. I think people are not gonna concede constantly, but who knows? I'll get to you once this game loads. Anyway, I really like Pokemon. Oh, there it is. I like Pokemon. I've enjoyed Pokemon for a long time. I enjoy playing around with moves and stuff. We're going to try to Mega Evolve, and then we're going to... Oh, it's Mega versus Mega. We're going to burn it so that it halves its attack. And that way, it deals, like, no damage. And he immediately... Okay, look. This is a well-ranked player, too. Why did you just insta-concede to a Sableye burning you? What is this game? Look, I don't even know what the rest of my team was. Oh, I don't get to see. I'll see it in the recording, but I didn't even see what the rest of my team was. We just... What is this? I got, like, 8 wins in a row the other day. Maybe I'm too low on the ladder for my skill level, but I just started playing again, like... very recently after watching some Frieza and stuff. So I watched a bunch of Pokemon challenges, I watched a bunch of Frieza, and suddenly I'm good at this. Like, when I was playing Bed Wars, it was like I watched a bunch of Technoblade, and then I got good at Bed Wars. So maybe that has something to do with it. There we go. There we go. Here's gonna be a very tough challenge, okay? Let's knock off on the Alakazam. Okay, never mind. I think we can knock this out with Aqua Jet, actually. Can Aqua Jet knock it out in the sun? That's a good question. We're gonna find out. No. So now he's lost 3 really good Pokemon. I gotta hope he doesn't have another really good Pokemon, right? Shaymin, back in Shaymin. We don't know what his other stuff is, but we could sacrifice this against the Shaymin. Yeah, okay. All right, now we try Ice Punching. It's not gonna work. I guess I should have sent out Shaymin earlier. Yeah, I definitely should have sent out my Shaymin earlier. My Shaymin's faster. I lost 2 Pokemon for no reason. Yeah, we lose this. Oh well.